Mm, you're quite right, Mrs. Corning. Now, we must get rid of this canker in our midst. As that boy was born to be a young man. I've never been so shocked in all me days.
Mr. Bumble, you must have had quite a turn. Sit down and have a nice cup of tea.
Nice to be appreciated, Mrs. Corning. And these here paupers and this here parish don't appreciate me. Anti-parochial they are, Mum. Anti-parochial. We've given away a matter of 20 loaves and a cheese and a half this very blessed afternoon. And still their paupers won't be contented.
Of course they're not. When would they be? Sweet Mr. Bumble?
Very sweet indeed, Mum.
Oh, little tinker, you.
I see you've got a cat. And kittens too, I declare.
And so fond of them, you can't imagine. And they're fond of their own too.
Mrs. Corny, Mum. I must say that any cat, or kitten for that matter, that could live in your home and not be fond of it is an idiot, Mum, and don't deserve to live in it.
Ooh, Mr. Bumble.
It's no use disguising facts, Mum. An idiot. And I am enjoying myself, but with pleasure.
You are a very cruel man. A very hard-hearted man and all.
Hard-hearted? Hard-hearted, you say? Are you hard-hearted, Mrs. Gordon?
Dear me. What a very curious question coming from a single man. What can you want to know for? Mr. Bumble, I shall scream!
Yes, you like it, come confess it. Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
Thank you.
with that boy, Mom. Boy, can't get him out of my life.
I'll drop the boy, Mom.
You would! Get a good price for it, Mr. Bumble.
One more.
Of course, my sweet.
more confidence in you. It doesn't matter whether you do or you don't. You can't sleep nowhere else.
Thank you.
No worries. You can't be helped now. Of course, you couldn't be helped then. You're very sorry for walking all that, but you must know, workers. Your mother was a regular rock-down bag.
What did you say?
A regular rock-down bag, and it's a good thing she died, but she did it. She's been doing hard labor in prison as like as not.
Mother?
No.
Father?
No.
Oh, lovely, balmy weather we're having today, don't you think? Are you staying in London?
Yes.
Got any lodging?
No.
Money?
Not a farthing.
Well.
Do you live in London?
When I'm alone. I suppose you want some place to sleep tonight, don't you? Are you accommodated?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, then accommodated you shall be, me all right. There's a certain house. And I have no respect for women who will give you lodgings for nothing. You never have to change. That is, if any other respectable gentleman he knows that you did. And does he know me? I should say he does not offer that example.
Well, who is this respectable old gentleman?
Is he a charity gentleman? Well, I wouldn't exactly say that. Not exactly. If I introduce someone, it's all right. On account of I happen to be a particular favorite of Mr. Fagin. That's his name, Mr. Fagin. By the way, if I'm introducing you to Fagin, I'd better know who you are from time to place.
My name's Oliver. Oliver Twist.
And me name's Jack Rockin. Better known among me more handsome friends as the Honorable Nacho.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. Rockins.
Come to think of it, I ain't got no intimate friends. I'm still, what the difference? You'll come with me for a sausage.
Well, are you sure Mr. Fagin will mind?
Mind? Consider yourself at home. Consider yourself one of the family. We've taken you so strong. It's clear we're going to get along. Consider yourself well in. Consider yourself part of the furniture. There is a lot
the honor of your intimate acquaintance. Leave him alone! We are very glad to see you, Oliver. Very. Charlie, do you want to turn me the fire? Don't you? Take off the sausages. Drink it, Jane. Come on.
Oliver, my dear, are we just long enough to wash, Oliver? Oh, that's all. Out to wash.
Yeah.
Is this a laundry then, sir?
Well, not exactly. I suppose a laundry would be a very nice thing indeed. But Anne, I'm afraid this place would be better, don't you, boys?
Thank you.
Dodger.
I've got two wallets.
Not as heavy as they might be, though. But very nice ones. Very ingeniously made. Ingenious workman, ain't he, Oliver?
Very ingenious, sir.
What have you got, Marvel?
Nose rags.
Oh, they're very nice ones. Yellow and green. I'm afraid you haven't embroidered them too well, though, my dear. We'll have to pick the initials out with a needle. You'll need to learn how to do this too, my dear. Won't you, boys?
Yes!
Of course, sir. Just do everything you saw Dodger and Charlie do. We can teach you how to make wallets. I just watch them. Especially Dodger. Why, he's going to be a regular little appeal size. And now, is it the fault? That my handkerchief is protruding from my pocket.
I can just see the corner.
No. Then try to take it out without me feeling it, like you saw the others do, my dear.
Trying to frighten you. You're a brave boy.
Ray. Did you see any of the pretty things, my dear?
Yes, sir.
Come on, Oliver. The only thing I've got left to do in the old age. A terrible thing. Old age.
Do you think I could get up now, sir?
Certainly, my poor. No feet. Certainly.
Quality, you sight.
waiting here for you when you come back. You can go, but be back soon. You can go, but while you're working, this place, some place around.
Thank you. report, Mr. Brownlow?
Yes, that's it.
Thank you.
Mansfield, a new boy, went out on his first job with George and he got nabbed. I'm afraid he may say something that would get us into trouble.
That's very likely. You're afloat upon again, Finnegan.
And I'm afraid that if the game were up with us, it would be up with a good many more. And it would come out the worse for you than it would for me, Margie.
Somebody must find what's been said or done. Now, he hasn't talked yet. There's still a chance we might get him back without suspicion. We didn't have him the moment he dares step foot out of the house. Now, who's gonna go?
The very thing! Why, Nancy, my dear, what do you say?
That it won't do, Finnegan, so it's no use of trying it on.
And just what do you mean by that remark?
What I say, Bill.
Why, Nancy, you're just the person for it. Nobody up that way knows anything about you.
And us, I don't want him to, neither. It's rather more no than yes with me, Bill.
She will go, Finnegan.
No, she won't, Finnegan.
Yes, she will, Finnegan. Go on! Get out!
Oh, yes, he does.
think you'll find a great improvement in the boy.
That, sir, is for me to decide.
How are you feeling today, my boy?
Much better, sir. May I stay here always, sir?
If you wish, dear boy, if you wish. The doctor is here to see you.
You are a great deal better, are you not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, I know you are. And you're hungry too, aren't you?
No, sir.
No, not hungry. You're not hungry, Mr. Brown,
no.
You're sleepy though, aren't you?
No, sir.
No, not sleepy. Not thirsty, are you? The boy's thirsty, I'll eat my head, sir. Are you?
Yes, rather thirsty, sir.
Just as I expected. It's very natural the boy should be thirsty. Make you some tea.
Certainly, doctor.
May I get up now, sir?
Certainly, take in some fresh air. Keep him warm and don't let him get too cold. Will you have the goodness?
Certainly, doctor. You'll be glad to be up again, Oliver. Doctor, you notice the most extraordinary likeness between that boy's face and the portrait of my daughter Agnes?
I can't say I do. I know two sort of boys. Meaty-faced boys and beef-faced boys.
And which is Oliver?
Meaty? Where did he come from?
Didn't I tell you? He was arrested for stealing my pocket handkerchief.
What, sir?
It was all my mistake. When the shopkeeper told us what really happened and he was released by the magistrate, I brought him here to make what amends I could. But I must confess, I found myself strangely attached to the child.
He's deceiving you, my good friend. He's had a fever. I'll not say this peculiar to good people. You're not bad people, bad people. He stole your pocket handkerchief and he'll steal more, sir.
He didn't. Yes, what is it?
What's your hotel, sir?
Ah, yes, thank you. Now I have some more. Hey, wait, come back. Yes. I particularly wish to have these books returned today.
Send your mother.
I'm sure he'll deliver it safely.
And if he does, I'll eat my head, sir.
Please let me take them, sir.
Very well. If you wish, you shall. Now, I'll tell you what I want you to do. I want you to take these books and say that you've come to pay £4 a can, Mr. Brown. Here's £5. There's no need to rush. It's just down the road. But I shall expect you back in 10 minutes. Let us see. 10 minutes.
Thank you. gentleman, fine guest.
Oh, delighted to see you looking so well, my dear. The artful daughter shall get you another suit for fear you should spoil that Sunday one. Why didn't you ride and tell us you were coming? We have had something warm for supper.
Hello, what's that? That's mine, Fagin.
No, no, my dear, my bill, mine. You shall have the books.
If that's not mine, mine and Nancy's, that is. Well, I'll just take the boy back again. Come on, hand over.
This is hardly fair, Bill.
Fair or not fair, hand over, I tell you. Hardly fair, is it, Nancy? Do you think Nancy and me have got nothing better to do with our time than spend it chasing your kids? Give it here, you avaricious old skeleton. Say, give it here. As far as share the trouble, I'm not helping up neither. It's not a library.
You can't keep those books. Send us to Brownlow's. And if he knows you have, he'll come after here looking for you.
So he'll come out here, will he? What did you tell him about us?
Nothing.
Well, that remains to be seen. If I find you said anything, anything out of place, Fagin,
I'll wager you the young scoundrel told him everything.
Stand off, put your head against the wall.
I don't care for that, Bill. The child shan't be armed unless you kill me first.
Oh, shan't he? I shall soon do that if you don't stand off.
No, no, come, come, Sykes. We've got the boy. What's the matter?
The girl's gone mad, I think.
No, she hasn't. Don't think it.
Then be quiet, will you?
No, I won't be quiet.
This violence.
I went away with you.
I don't care for that, Bill. You've caught him here. What moment you have? Let be.
Or I shall put my mark on someone and not care for the consequences.
Are you? Nancy, you're a wonderful actress, isn't it? A wonderful.
Am I? Take care I don't overdo it. Because I'm one of you. I'll put the finger on some of you. I don't care if I hang with you.
You. Do you know who you are and what you are?
Yes. I know all about it. Who I am and what I am.
Well, keep quiet. I'll quiet you for a good long time to come. You're nice in coming out this humane and genteel rubbish. A pretty subject for the child, as you call him, to make a friend of.
Lord help me, I am. And I wish I'd been struck dead in the street before I lent a hand in bringing him here today. After today, he's a thief and a liar. And all that's bad from this day forth. Isn't that enough for you without beating him to death?
Civil words, Sykes. Civil words.
Ah, yes. You deserve it, Grumpy.
But you have it, your living.
Living, yeah, yeah. Some living, some living.
What words have you had?
No getting or giving.
Must we have murders yet? Though we turn our trophies at us.
For you mean
no one. Watch out, Nancy, hang on her.
Thank you. who can sew for me and come for me and go for me and go for me and maggot me. The finger she would maggot me, the money she would take from me, the misery she'd make from me. I think I'd better nip it out again.
sugar tongs and a milk pot, some secondhand furniture, and 20 pounds cash. I went very reasonably.
Mr. Sowerberry, the undertaker, took him from us for £5.
me say, you sold him like an animal?
It was all Mrs. Bumble. She authorized the sale.
Really? Then I'll see to it that neither of you are employed in a situation of trust again. You may leave my house.
This poor little unfortunate circumstance will not deprive him of my parochial office.
Indeed it will. And you may think yourself well off besides.
But it was all Mrs. Bumble. She would do it.
That's no excuse for your presence on the occasion when the boy was sold, and indeed are the more guilty of this thing in the eye of the law. For the law supposes that your wife acted under your direction.
If the law supposes that, then the law is an ass! If that's the eye of the law, then he is a bachelor! And the worst that I can hope for the law is that his eye may be open by experience, sir! By experience!
Dear, the young person is a bachelor, sir. I actually say that she's come out all of them.
It's better to look at this. Do you see who this is?
Why, it's Miss Agnes, sir.
Yes, my daughter Agnes. And I have every reason to believe that Oliver is her child.
Sir! I can't stay out there any longer. If I'd gone away as Minnie would have done, you might have been sorry, and not without reason, neither.
I'm sorry, Benoit has been rude to you. How can I help you?
I don't know. Can she be trusted?
Yes, why?
I am the girl that took little Oliver back to old Fagin's on the morning he left this house.
You?
Yes, and I wish now I'd never been part of it. The boy mentioned you specially,
where
and
is
I thought...
Where's speak of, Fagin's?
No, I can't tell you.
Did you perhaps know that Oliver is probably my grandchild?
I didn't know nothing. All I knew was the orders. I had to get it back or suffer for it. You don't believe me. I don't want your pity. I had to come, even though they'll know someone murdered me if they knew I'd been here.
But where is Oliver? Where is this Fagin's?
I can't tell you that. I just wanted you to know that Oliver is safe. Let's go back now, quickly.
But what can I do about all this? Why can't you tell me where it is? Why must you go back to those people? I can call the Bow Street Runners in a moment, and if you tell them what you just told me, they would see to it that you come to no harm.
Don't you understand? I want to go back. I must go back there. How can I explain? You see, back there's a man that I just can't leave. You see, I love him. You don't know what it's like to love someone like that.
I understand.
My dear ladies, do excuse me, but I am anxious about the boy. How can you help me?
I won't tell you where he is, but I'll bring him to you. Nadia, that's too dangerous. Will you promise I won't be watched or followed?
I promise you solemnly.
Then tonight, between 11 and the time the clock strikes 12, I will walk on London Bridge. I will bring Oliver.
saw someone rapidly disappearing in the other direction.
Can you tell me what he looked like?
He was a heavy, broad-shouldered man.
Anything else?
He wore a brown coat and a black hat.
Yo, Sykes! It's Nancy! He's bringing Nancy!
Somebody change.